Lá sou Nuno do NSYNC. Oh, não. Sou Nuno do Extreme. Para agora, Rihanna. E vocês estão vendo e ouvindo Look House Rock Show. Rock and roll, baby.
Look House Rock Show, comparecendo aqui na Expo Music 2011. A gente vai dar um rolê e mostrar para vocês tudo o que está acontecendo nessa feira dos músicos, dos instrumentos. E ficamos sabendo que o Nuno Bittencourt, guitarrista monstro do Extreme, vai estar aqui. Vamos tentar trocar uma ideia com ele e perguntar que porra é essa de ser guitarrista da Rihanna. A gente gosta dele no Extreme. Nos acompanhe.
House Rock Show tá aqui na Expo Music 2011 e agora a gente vai entrevistar o Nuno Bittencourt. What's up, Nuno?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm great. Thank you. So, tell us, what are you doing here in Brazil this time?
Well, last time I think Extreme was here was 92. And it took me 20 years because I walked. I was walking back. So it took me about 20 years to walk from LA to São Paulo. That's why. Yeah, I apologize. It took so long. But, okay. No, I'm here. What am I doing here? I don't even know. I heard there was beer, so I'm here. But I'm here for Ibis, right? That's what I'm here for, right? But I'm in town with Rihanna. I happened to be here with Rihanna and had a day off, so I came to say hi to you.
Thank you. Hi to the So you're playing with Rihanna in Rock in Rio, right?
Yeah, tomorrow. We played in São Paulo, last week?
Last week.
This week, yeah. That was amazing.
Brasília.
Brasília, Belo Horizonte, all of that. So it was amazing. It was really amazing, yeah.
Nice. And what do you think playing now with Rihanna? Because before you are from a rock band. Do you like pop music or is like a job or you really like pop music?
No, you know, I would never have done this for a job. You know, I never really toured with anybody else other than Extreme and I've always been a little bit of a Rihanna fan, even though it's kind of pop, but I always thought she was a little bit edgy, a bit different. And the only reason I did it is because a friend of mine called me. He was working with her, and he said that if you do this, you get to be you. You know, you get to use the same sounds that you have with Extreme. You get to, you know, do. And it was kind of cool. I thought it was very interesting to take a bunch of music with no guitar and add guitar to it. So I was really interested, you know, and I was supposed to do it for 3 months. And I just liked it, you know. It's been fun, and I've become a bit more family with Rihanna, you know. And I try to quit like twice already.
But really?
She keeps asking me to come back, and it's very.
Of course, who wouldn't?
It's very hard to say no to Rihanna. She's so sweet, you know. People always ask me how is she as a person, and she's incredible. You know, she's such a sweet girl, and she's always been very respectful to everybody, and none of this diva stuff. You know, she's always a happy girl and very cool, very sweet.
And talking about pop music, what do you think about NSYNC who did a version of More Than Words? Have you ever listened to it?
NSYNC?
Yes! Didn't you know it?
No, they didn't do it. Are you sure about that?
I'm pretty sure.
You sure?
I'm pretty sure.
I didn't know about that one. I mean, I know there was an English boy band that did it. It was, what the hell was the name of that band? I can't remember. But there was an English band that did it, and I know there was an R&B, some guy named Frankie J or something, but I had no idea NSYNC did it.
Yes.
I mean, Justin was in NSYNC, wasn't he?
Yes, at least.
But wait a second. I just was in the studio with Justin about 2 months ago, and he didn't say anything about doing More Than Words. I thought he would have mentioned
really?
He did it. I want proof. I want proof.
I will download it and show you.
Okay?
You just put in More Than Words NSYNC.
I will do it.
And what about Extreme? Is there any hope that you guys come to Brazil and do a new tour around here, South America?
I have to tell you that being here right now, I'm really embarrassed. Like I feel ashamed because
why?
Because you know, seeing the fact that the last time we were here, the crowds and you know, an Extreme was
hard hot.
Yeah, you know what? And the fact that we haven't been here in 20 years is really bad. I think it's really bad. And
yeah, you need to come back.
I want to apologize how bad that really is. Because now coming, I feel bad because I'm back here with Rihanna for the first time in 20 years. That's terrible. I mean, not terrible that I'm with Rihanna, but terrible that I haven't been here with Extreme. So we're coming back for sure.
Really? Is that a promise?
I promise.
You promise me?
What? If it's true that NSYNC did more than words, then I'll come back.
Oh my God.
It all depends. Hey, it's up to her.
It's up to me. Yeah. Blame me. Westlife, not NSYNC. Westlife. Please. Mia culpa. Minha culpa, gente. Na verdade é do Edu, porque ele que mandou eu falar isso, tá?
Você acha que eu manjo de boy band?
É tudo a mesma coisa, por isso que a gente não sabe essa merda.
Em 5, Westlife, é tudo uma bosta, mano. Por isso que eu errei. Isso aí que se foda. E aí galera, eu tô aqui no stand da Line 6 ESP. E eu tava passando por aqui, ouvi um Sweet Child O' Mine do Guns N' Roses muito bem tocado. Eu falei, vamos ver quem tá tocando isso, porque tá bom pra caralho. E me deparo com esse cara aqui, meu. Qual teu nome?
Jonathan Bastos.
Jonathan Bastos. Quanto tempo você toca guitarra, velho?
2 anos.
E a gente vai mostrar pra vocês. Já foi Sweet Child O' Mine, agora ele falou que vai tocar pra gente Nirvana, Smells Like Teen Spirit. A gente vai dar uma olhada e depois eu volto para falar com ele. Vocês viram o que eu vi? O cara apavorou, velho. Meu, Jonathan, eu quero te agradecer em nome de todo mundo que tá aqui de boca aberta por essa aula de guitarra e essa aula de vida e superação. Eu tô, meu, emocionado, é inacreditável. Parabéns, cara. Muita boa sorte pra você. Você apavorou a moçada, velho. Muito obrigado.
Valeu, obrigado, galera. E é isso aí.
Tô aqui com um dos maiores guitarristas do Brasil, Eduardo Anui, do Dr. Sim. Tudo certo?
Tudo bom? E aí, pessoal? Tudo legal?
Tranquilo, tranquilo. Edu, quais vocês vão estar aqui de novo na Expo Music? Você tá assim por aqui, trabalhando com guitarras e tal. Conta um pouquinho pra gente como é estar aqui.
Então, pra mim, já faz parte da minha rotina, né? Eu já frequento isso há uns 12 anos ou mais, nem me lembro.
E fala um pouquinho pra gente desse disco novo, por favor.
O Animal é um disco que, na minha opinião, provavelmente é um dos melhores da nossa carreira, né? Todo artista fala isso sobre o último disco, mas é um disco um pouco mais direto, objetivo, menos complexo do que o anterior, que era o Bravo, e mais com melodias muito boas, com riffs muito viscerais.
Beleza, então escutem o Animal, Dr. Sim. Falou!
Bianca Jordão, na estande da Janine. Eles vão fazer um show agora com Lila, né, Bianca?
Isso aí, a gente